For question number 139, the correct option is option number 3. And to show how we arrived there, let's show some steps of solution. We draw a quick figure. This is a viscous liquid through which a solid sphere of radius r is falling downwards with a constant terminal velocity. I use this blue arrow to show that. And the viscous or drag force given by the liquid is acting vertically upwards against the motion of this sphere. So this viscous force, I'll be calling it as FD, D for drag, and the terminal velocity with which the sphere is falling downwards, that will be calling the VT vector. Now the rate of heat production or heat dissipation is equal to the negative of the power spent by the drag force to resist the falling motion of the sphere. So recalling definition of power from mechanics, you can write down the power spent by the drag force against this sphere's motion is dot product of the force and velocity vectors. So force vector is FD directed vertically upwards dot velocity vector VT directed vertically downwards. Obviously, this product is coming out to be minus FD into VT. Let me write that in scalar. This is coming out to be minus FD into VT for the simple reason. Let me show separately. The drag force is upwards, velocity vector of the body on which the force acts is downwards. And therefore, the angle between these two vectors, this theta is equal to 180 degree, and cos theta coming in the expression FD dot VT is equal to FD VT cos 180 degree. Cos 180 is minus 1, and that's where the power spent by this viscous force against the motion of the sphere is minus FD VT. But by definition, the rate of heat production is the negative of this power, and therefore you can write down the rate at which heat is produced, dQ dT. That will be, I'm saying again, the rate at which heat is produced, that is dQ dT, will be equal to the absolute value of this power spent by the drag force, that is simply FD into VT. Now, at this point, recall Stokes' law giving the drag force expression for a sphere of radius r. Let me write it first. The drag force is 6 pi eta r into VT. And VT is already there. In the expression for FD, the drag force, eta is the viscosity coefficient of the liquid, r is radius of the sphere, VT is the speed of this sphere, which is terminal speed when it is falling down with a constant terminal speed here. So seeing rate of heat production can be written as 6 pi eta into r into VT square. This is my equation number 1. And what we have done so far can be taken to be the step 1 of the solution. In step number 2, we call another important formula from the theory classes. The terminal speed of the falling sphere twice r square g into rho minus rho f divided by 9 eta. In the expression r is radius of the sphere, g is free fall acceleration, rho is density of the solid's material, the sphere's material, rho f is density of this viscous liquid, eta is the viscosity coefficient for the liquid. So when you put it here, rather let me write this thing as Vt is equal to some constant into r square, isn't it? Here g is a constant at a given place, densities are constant, viscosity coefficient is a constant. Therefore, I could write simply Vt is equal to k r square, and if I combine this with equation number 1, we are getting, in that case, the rate of heat production dq dt is equal to 6 pi eta 1r is already there, and let us write vt as kr square. This is the whole square, and it's coming out to be 6 pi eta into k square into r to the power 5. And once again, 6 pi eta k square being a constant quantity, we conclude that the rate of heat production dq dt must be varying directly as the fifth power of the sphere radius, and that is the option number 3 in the question. You choose this one.